All right, so before we dive into the slides, I just want to provide a little bit of background on why this session is really important here at FreshBooks. As Paco mentioned, I joined FreshBooks earlier this year, and we kicked off the new Accounting Professionals Program. And this session has really important that Mike gets an opportunity to speak to all of you and share this pivotal time at FreshBooks, really why we're choosing now to engage with the accounting community and give his insights in terms of the support that's going into the Accounting Professionals Program and supporting the Accounts Channel. Paco, I'm not sure if you're able to share your screen, but we don't have the slides yet, but I'll just keep moving along. In the interest of time, I am Twyla, as Paco mentioned, and I'm not going to spend a ton of time on myself. We're not here to talk to me. We're here to meet our special guest, which is Mike McDerment, the CEO of FreshBooks. And Mike, so thank you so much for taking time out of your day today and sharing with us all that you're bringing to light in terms of the Accounting Professionals Program. So Mike, maybe just take a moment to introduce yourself, please.
Okay, thank you, Twyla. And you know, for those who haven't had a chance to meet Twyla yet, or maybe those who have, just how wonderful she is. And we're so lucky to have you here leading this effort for us. It's been just wonderful working with you. So very excited about what we can do. And so just a little bit about me, because we're gonna spend some time on our story, but you know, I'm Mike, I founded the company over a decade ago. I live in Toronto, Canada. We have customers in over 100 countries. The U.S. is our largest market, and it's wonderful to be running an international business. I am a father of three, a husband and a father of three. So I have three young children that are keeping us busy, and they're five and under, including an infant about 8 months. So COVID has been quite an odyssey from a parenting and mental health and everything else standpoint that I'm sure many of you can relate to on one vector or another. So pleased to be here today, and really looking forward to the time together and Q&A towards the end.
Excellent. Thanks, Mike. And you know, before we go any further and I start to ask you these questions that I'm sure that everyone wants to know, I just want to share, as Paco mentioned, this is intended to be a casual conversation. We are going to be allowing for some Q&A at the end. Obviously, with their technical difficulties, we might get a little crunch for time, but go ahead and pop those into the Q&A section. We want to be able to hear what you have for questions and answer them. And if we can't answer them now, we'll make sure to follow up with you afterward. Also, as Paco mentioned, I will stick around afterwards to do a demo inside of the new FreshBooks platform, showcase some of the things that the features that really accounting professionals are really wanting to see and are excited about. So that'll be at the end of our talk here with Mike. All right, let's get into some questions. So I think it's really important that we start at the beginning. So Mike, tell us about the origin of FreshBooks, and did you ever dream that the company would turn into what it's become today?
Okay, and Paco, I think you wanna advance a slide if you would be so kind. So. The short answer is no, I had no idea, but let me explain why that is. And I think it has to do with where I started out. I built FreshBooks for myself. So I was running a small design agency. I was working from home, and, one day I was using Word and Excel to bill my clients. Now you might say, why were you using Word and Excel? Well, I think we all know that most people use Word and Excel. but to add to the why a little more, I had studied, I'd been to business school and studied accounting. And my little quip with that is always, I know about LIFO, FIFO, all that good stuff that you learn at least at the basic, the intro and the 201, 101, 301, all that good stuff. Having said that, I left business school. I started a couple of businesses. And that's what led me to building this design firm. So I saved over that invoice and decided there had to be a better way to do things. I did look at the alternatives. I looked at some of the accounting software that was available at the time. And I just thought it was incredibly cumbersome. And so instead of I actually bought the product. And this is also common. People would buy the accounting software. And then not use it. So I bought QuickBooks and didn't use it. And I'm sure that's true of many of your clients and people you know as small business owners as well. Anyhow, I decided it was just way too cumbersome and built something instead for myself to bill my clients. I think what's interesting, and part of the reason that product was so overwhelming, was because I was running a design firm, and you know, my real problem was receivables. And so I started out with just easy invoicing, and I didn't need everything else. And that was our starting place at FreshBooks. And over time, you know, as we got going, we took a while to get to launch and we got the product out there. We realized people needed other things, and we started helping them with that. So our journey has been really listening to customers and improving the offering over time. It took us, as I shared in the prior version before the technology interrupted us, it took us 2 years to get to 10 customers paying us $9.95 a month each. Okay, and my co-founders were a doctorate in computer science. I was a business school student, and my other co-founder was an electrical engineer. So pretty well-educated folks. And we had really not, you know, we'd really failed by most people's measures. And so, but instead of packing up, we ended up going and moving into my parents' basement for 3.5 years. We got to about 2,000 customers before we got out of there. And we've been growing ever since. And so today, FreshBooks is paying customers in over 100 countries. We're over 400 people. We're number two by, you know, sort of gross profit in America for small business accounting software, which may be a surprise to you. And so if you ask me, would we ever get there? You know, I wouldn't have necessarily guessed that. And it's very exciting. Having said that, the reason was because, you know, I hadn't worked anywhere else. I didn't know any other way of doing things than running my small agency. And it's been quite a bit to learn how to build a software company.
Excellent. Thanks for sharing about that. And it's no doubt about it that no matter what business you're starting, it's hard. And it's a hard start. It's hard to keep going. It's hard to get through those ebbs and flows. So thanks for sharing a bit about your journey. So a bit off script, Paco, if you don't mind advancing the slide. It's an exciting day here at FreshBooks, and if you've caught any of our social media posts or anything else that we've put online, we made a big announcement this morning that FreshBooks has done its first acquisition with a company called Factorama, based out of Mexico. Really exciting day for us. I'm sure that you're thrilled as well, Mike, that we're at this point that we can announce it and that we can really put the feather in our cap with having our first acquisition as a company. So that kind of cues us up for, you know, a little bit more about the growth. So maybe even share with folks, you started it at the beginning, where are we at now, you know, in terms of a company, and what's that journey been like for you? You did touch on that a bit, but maybe if there's anything else you want to add.
Well, I really, it is great news. So thank you very much, Giovanni. It's really exciting for us at FreshBooks too. So we're grateful to the team at Factorama for choosing to become part of, to join us at FreshBooks as well. So that's great. So yeah, that journey, at the end of the day, I am an owner. I built the software to solve my own problems. And I continue to build the software to solve my own problems and those of others like me. And talk about how that relates to spending time building the account program, why the time is right for that now. But we started out those humble beginnings in the basement. And along the way, I've learned, and we've raised, you know, a lot of capital in the past few years. I waited over a decade to bring on any institutional capital. In the last 4 or 5 years, we brought on a lot to help further our growth and our initiatives. And with that capital and all the experience we have as an organization serving the small business market and designing for owners, we basically just have a lot more capability now to go ahead and serve people in ways. And so so we get to do things like acquisition, we get to get the accountant program going. But I think the thing that's been consistent throughout all this for me as a founder is, again, I started out as an owner. I had no idea how to build a software company or a product company. And it's just been a journey of learning, unlearning, and relearning. And that is as a very common theme. It's been like I am constantly reconstituting my internals to try and figure out how to keep up with the growth of the business and ideally how to accelerate further it. And I feel like, you know, we're all lucky if we have careers where we get to challenge ourselves and have personal growth. I feel very privileged in that regard, and it's been a lot of fun, and there's still much, much more to do.
Excellent. Thanks very much. And I think that really kind of kicks off the next part of our conversation, which where we're going to talk a bit about the core values, and you know, when you talked about learning and unlearning, I'm sure that there's some things that have stayed really constant inside of FreshBooks, and I feel confident based on everything that I know about FreshBooks that the values inside of the company would play a part in that. And it was certainly one of the things that really attracted me to FreshBooks when we started our discussions, was the core values and the importance of that really came through. And I saw that from our first discussions with everyone at FreshBooks. And of course, now inside of FreshBooks, I see it and feel it and live it every day. And so maybe just share with us a bit about those company values and the culture and how this came to be.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and say, I think to sustain and survive great change, which we have over the years, you need to have a solid foundation. And that's true of, you know, relationships. Maybe you've chosen to marry or something like that along the way, and you have a partnership with anyone or a friendship. Let's take any friendship. Just having that baseline, and probably underlying that, whether you know it or not, it's a common value set. And so, yeah, so for us at FreshBooks, as I was in the basement trying to figure out how to build a business, I became a student of culture and how to create it. When I started out, I'd never worked anywhere else. I didn't understand what culture was. So my analogies were like, you know, undergrad and high school and like a summer camp I went to. I really didn't understand what culture was, but it was impressed upon me. It was the difference between good companies and great companies. And I really wanted to build a great company. And so I started trying to learn, you know, what is culture? How is it defined? You know, and then ultimately, how do you influence it? Which became, you know, very confusing because it's such a squishy topic. So I, you know, I became a student, and for those, you know, I'll give you my definition of culture, which is, you know, it's what happens when nobody's looking. Okay. And I think that, so there's companies where if there's a piece of garbage on the floor, people walk past it. And there's companies where people pick it up and put it in the garbage. And you know, I know which kind of a company I want to be a part of. And so that is, you know, that is one way to look at culture. And then as I became a student of culture, I studied this. It was brought to my attention that to sustain culture and to scale it and grow it and keep a company, you know, feeling special when you interact with them, having a strong culture, you really need to have a set of governing kind of rules for behaviors. And those are what values are inside a company. And so we did some work in the early years. Well, frankly, in the earliest years, you don't have to worry about defining culture because, you know, we were all sitting in the same room. I interacted with everybody every day. But as we got to about 15, 20 people, we decided to try and, it was really distill and document the values we believed we were already living. And we ran an exercise where we got everybody, the whole company together, and everybody sort of, it took in its first incarnation about a half day. And we went around and we like talked about what are the behaviors you're most proud of here? And people put stuff on the wall as like stickies. And then we kind of organized them into themes. And then we tried to give a name to those themes and write a little bit of definition as well. And so we came up with things like passion. And, you know, our definition of passion is about, you know, we are constantly working on our craft. If we weren't doing it here, we'd be doing it somewhere else. And I'm sure many of you, as you think about, you know, how you've chosen to build your careers and what you love doing, you know, you recognize passion yourself. You're constantly learning about it. You're here at this webinar, learning about something to help further yourself in the profession. And so we really like to, I believe in this world that is more knowledge-based in the economy and everything else. Like, you know, we cannot pay people to learn what we want them to at FreshBooks. So we need to hire people who want to learn, and their interests in learning are aligned with where we're going. And so passion is a really important thing we look for in people. And then another one I'll highlight today is empathy. And we define that one as, we're a team, we listen and we care, we solve problems together. And so I think all of those things really matter. To me, that's our proxy for emotional intelligence. Can you fully listen? Or does only 80% of what I say go through to you? And do you have the emotional awareness to know how you're reacting or responding in things? And because if you don't, you know, our communication, our collaboration is going to be thwarted. And so, I guess I'm running a little long on this topic. Obviously, I'm very passionate about it. But those are some of the values we have. And I think they've helped govern the growth and scale of the company. And then I think there's a final thing that's really important. And so while we have all of those, we have 9 values. They spell Porch Fest. I told you about 2 of them. There's the North Star of how we organize and, you know, live those values every day is what we call the 4 E's, which is to execute extraordinary experiences every day. And what that means is, and I think, you know, I think 4E is a credo that everyone who runs a firm and has clients can relate to. The first E is execute. If you don't get things done, bad things happen, right? So you need to get things done. That's actually job one. Extraordinary is about exceeding client expectations. And I think to be extraordinary is, yeah, you exceed expectations. So if you tell somebody you're going to do something, do it. You know, follow up on time or in advance. So if you tell a client, I'll be in touch with you by Monday, and you get in touch with them Tuesday, you've broken a promise. You've not lived up to their expectations. If you get in touch with them Friday with the deliverable, they're getting the Friday in advance, I should say, they're going to be happy with that. So these kinds of things, experiences are what people are looking for. You know, while people may be hiring you and your firm to get work done for them, the experience of working with you is really what's going to keep them with you and have them refer. So you want to think about, what's the experience I deliver to my clients, not just did I balance the books this month. And then finally, every day, you know, you can do, you know, 10 month ends in a row that are great. And if the 11th is poor, then people are going to be upset, and you're going to have broken the kind of the spell of being a, like, a company that's living 4E. So we really try to live 4E, and I really hope that's your experience in going with us. And Twyla, thank you for all the time on that one. It's a topic near and dear to my heart.
No, I give you all the time in the world to talk about that. It's pretty near and dear to my heart as well. And something that I share with every partner that's coming into the program is really that human side of FreshBooks and what really matters outside of the product. There's a lot of heart in FreshBooks, and I'm happy to have you spend time on that. All right, so let's talk a little bit. You shared the part of the company's mission, especially in the early stages, was to build a platform for business owners. And this came out of your own need, create a solution to a problem that you had. And so tell us, why was it so important that you as a founder, that you have FreshBooks built for the business owner rather than for the accountant?
Well, I guess I did end up touching on that a little bit. You know, I had studied business in school at one of the world's best business schools, most owners haven't. Most owners go into whatever it is that they're doing because they're passionate about their craft, and they love serving others and their clients and delivering for them. And I'm sure those are relatable things for each of you who are on the call. So if you marry those two things as like the priorities, and you think about all the stuff that comes with running a business and building one, like kind of that, if you want the back office kind of work, it's not something that people envision when they think about going into business for themselves. It's kind of this necessary evil. And, you know, by and large, it comes with a lot of complexity. It can be highly intimidating, and not to mention time consuming. And so what I want to do is go and build something that I thought was appropriate for my needs and others like me. So I think it was really easy to use. The language was relatable. The product was intuitive. It didn't need an instruction manual. I could just start using it, and they would roughly keep me out of trouble and then have me be ready for tax time. And as we started to build it, so like employees could do log in and do things like track time, I really knew, hey, it needed to be so easy to use that people would actually use it. And so, you know, I didn't have a feeling as I looked at the market and the other products that were being used, and I don't mean to disparage anyone else's offering, but it just didn't feel like it was built for me. And so you can think about it like Goldilocks syndrome or something like this, where it's like, well, this doesn't taste right, or it's too hot or too cold, or the bed's not comfortable. You know, that I really wanted something that worked for me. And we have tried to stay true to that, you know, throughout for FreshBooks. We really, really have. And in, you know, what that's looked like is, you know, we really focus on certain kinds of customers to the exclusion of others. Like we don't really serve retail businesses. You know, we don't really serve, if you have a point of sale solution, that's not, you know, like it's your full-time thing, like all your clients are checking out. Like that's not who we are serving. We're building service-based businesses that have, you know, relationships, and, you know, maybe you'll do a point of sale thing in the field, but it's a different thing. And what that lets us do is keep the product simple, in language that's relatable. And I just felt that there were enough people out there like me who really didn't want to become accountants, but did need to use software to be successful and organize their books, that something should be done. And so that's the biggest innovation we've ever made at FreshBooks, is we built for owners instead of accountants as the first thing.
Yeah, great. Thanks for sharing that. And I do think it's important for everyone to hear kind of why that was the intention of FreshBooks from the beginning. And I honestly think that the beta best software that I use tends to be one that's built for an actual pain point that that person had, as opposed to, I think I have no problem and a solution that I'm going to create a software for, but that it's actually, that doesn't seem to be as good as when it's actually like, I have a problem, I'm going to build something to solve it. it tends to create a great platform and a great software from my experience. All right, so next question then is, as a leader, you've talked about the product, even in our last question, you made a really big decision inside of FreshBooks to revamp FreshBooks entirely in 2016. So tell us what drove that decision and what are some of the biggest differences that folks can find inside of new FreshBooks compared to the classic version?
Yes. Okay. So FreshBooks Classic, we started building, frankly, in the basement. We didn't know anything about software development, product design, anything like this. And we built, this incredibly successful platform just by listening to customers and iterating. Having said that, almost no software platform lasts more than a decade and gets to the other side of that, and people feel like it's contemporary and all these kinds of things. And so the world had changed so much since we built the first version of new FreshBooks. Like, mobile devices were not a thing. And the technologies to build applications like this didn't exist. And I won't bore you with the technical details, but let's just go ahead and say the world had changed, consumer expectations had changed. And I came to believe that for reasons that are largely technical in nature, I just didn't think that our future would be as bright if we just kept iterating on FreshBooks Classic. I felt like we needed to do a flash cut to something better and more modern. And that was actually, even taking the lessons we learned over a decade and figure out how we could make the product even easier to use. So we wanted it to both be easier to use and to do a better job of serving some of our larger customers. So those were the two goals of building new FreshBooks. And we've done a lot to put it in there to improve that. And for example, small things that you may not be aware of that new FreshBooks has that Classic didn't, for example, are journal entries. And, because we're focused on serving larger customers now with new FreshBooks, those customers need, journal entries. And by the way, they need accountants working more closely with them as well. And so that's part of why this program exists. But I'm sure we'll spend more time there.
Yeah, thanks for that. And I'm kind of just keeping my eye a little bit on the questions. And I think you probably answered one of those questions as we went through in terms of journal entries being inside of new FreshBooks, a double entry accounting, financial statements inside a new FreshBooks. So it's exciting for the accounting profession to be able to see that the new software or the new platform that came out in 2016 has really enhanced an accountant's experience inside of FreshBooks.
I'll just build one thing on that. It has so far, and the rate of change and acceleration between just huge investments we're making, but also we built the new software so we could move faster. Whatever you see today, I encourage you to keep checking in because we're moving so fast.
Yeah, absolutely. The product features that have launched since I started are quite a few, and it's exciting for sure. All right. So, although we currently have thousands of users across 120 countries, which is really exciting. And earlier we talked about our acquisition of Factorama, which is really going to be a big step into Mexico. But prior to now, really FreshBooks hasn't engaged with the accounting community recently. And so that's really prompting this natural question that folks are wondering as to why has FreshBooks chosen now to launch this program and re-engage with the accounting community? What brought us to that decision and kind of maybe just share your insights on that, Mike?
No, it's a very reasonable question. And full disclosure, we did do something a number of years ago that was a start with something like this. And many of you, thankfully, did go ahead and get involved with that. But I will say, that we kind of slowly wound that program down. And this is something entirely different. We have a much greater degree of focus and investment and clarity around what and why we're doing behind the program we're running today. And please, I want to go ahead and disclose that we did that and let you know this is a very different thing now. And so what is different? Well, from a strategic standpoint, at the heart of new FreshBooks was a better understanding of our customers, as I mentioned. And one of them is that our customers and we call them owners. They work with a variety of stakeholders to help them succeed. So certainly their clients, certainly their employees, in many cases contractors. One of the really important roles is actually their accountant. Okay. And so part of building out our platform and living our vision of new FreshBooks is actually to help facilitate working with accountants in a graceful way. Okay. So that's thing one. You marry that with, that's a customer insight. We know that we didn't start till now because we didn't feel like we were ready to do it right. But now we've built out a bunch of new FreshBooks. We're ready to do it right. And we just have a whole bunch more organizational capability, another level of investment to go ahead and do it right. And so I think those are the two big things for this. And then if you go back to like, hey, what does living the four E's look like? Well, we want to make sure we do that, for our owners who really, in many cases, need to work with an accountant. And we want to help facilitate that, but also for you folks as you get involved.
Yeah, excellent. Thank you. All right, Paco, if you don't mind advancing the slides, really then that kind of cues us up for this question, which is how do you think that FreshBooks can really help to accountants accounting firm owners to build more collaborative practices in the future?
Yep. I think, again, I talked about those roles and how we think about them, right? I think, you have a similar world where you work with clients and, different constituents to make things go. And I think ideally the role FreshBooks plays for you folks is to help owners successfully, perform some jobs that you don't want to be doing. Okay. And that the owners should be doing. And I've always thought of, invoicing as one of those jobs and some of the receipt capture and things like this. But, to have to we do have owners out there that go and say, hey, I need, email their accountant and say, can you send an invoice to this person? Which to me is just, you were just talking with the client, write down the details. You should be able to do this in a heartbeat on whatever device you're on right now. And so we want to, first of all, set things up so the owners are performing the jobs they should. And that so things are, as easy as possible for them to do that and to do it successfully. So you don't have a lot of mistakes downstream. And I think we have a good track record of helping owners do those things. I think that's super important. We want to build it again in a way that it's so easy to use that they actually do it, because I imagine you all have recommended a piece of software and the owners are like, yeah, I'm glad I hired you. And like, no, I'm not doing that. Or I started and I didn't bother or whatever. And so I think just again, that ease of use and that owner orientation in our building, it's actually built for them, not you. I think that's a good thing. That's a good thing, and we will do work to make sure that the things that you need to do can get done successfully. But the experience in the owner's account is really from the start designed for them so that they're set up for success. And then I think if we do all those things well, I think we get to a place where you folks can elevate, right? And you can work on your advisory services and focus on, presenting value as opposed to nagging them to log their, get your invoices in so I can close out the month or whatever it is, that's just not the relationship you want to have with your clients. You want to have them doing that and you talk to them about, okay, here's what I see and here's what, together we can help you do to get the next steps so you can prosper.
You might have caught me chuckling there a little bit because I've lived the experience of putting the software in front of a client and then kind of being the nagging mom that's trying to get them to do their piece of the workflow. And I hear partners that are joining the program having that same challenge. And so that's why you might have caught me giggling there, because it was just, it was bringing back memories from my time in the firm and hearing partners say that very thing.
We see it again and again across the platform. Things like time tracking, oh, it's such a chore. It's like, well, our job is to build, we have that available, yeah. Build it in a way that it's so easy to use, people use it. But anyhow, that's it's a big deal. It's design, user experience, and building it for the end user and not, for the, it's a subtle but very different thing in how we operate at FreshBooks.
Yeah, you bet. All right, Mike, I'm going to tell you something that here's what I've been hearing from partners who are joining the program. They've been sharing with me these, if I quote some of them, it sounds like this: Mike was ahead of his time. And then that prompts me, of course, to ask them, well, why is that? And then they quickly go to the fact that you spoke about value pricing in advance of our industry, the accounting industry, really having that as a hot topic front and center, like we have it now, that, getting out of that time trap and doing hourly billing is something that the accounting profession has discussions about at large. And really everyone's trying to work towards value pricing if they're not already there. And so maybe share with us a bit about your earlier experience and what prompted you to write a book on value pricing, and what are some of the key lessons that the folks that are on this call might be able to take away from that book writing?
Yeah, so I'll go ahead and just say for those who are not aware, I did in fact write a book on value pricing. It's called Breaking the Time Barrier. It is it has been downloaded over 250,000 times. It's free. Okay, you can read it in 45 minutes. And I like to give people the disclaimer that it's written like a fable. So I warned you. But if you can invest the 45 minutes, even if you're already doing value pricing today, I promise you it will help. And so I wrote it because I would go out to dinner not during COVID, unfortunately, but when I travel, I'll invite customers in that area out for dinner and we talk. And they were always talking about, well, how do I price my services? They didn't understand how to set a price. And, you know, I had learned some things from back when I was running my firm that I wanted to pass on. And that was really the story of value pricing. And so the purpose of the book, Breaking the Time Barrier, is to help people with the mind shift. And it is a big mind shift. It's like it's the book's purpose is to help you make the mind shift from, you know, time and materials or whatever it is that you're doing, project-based, to value-based pricing. And it's not easy, but it can be done. And, that's what the book is about. And so I just thought the world needed it. I had learned some things, you know, why not share those? And, I'm glad people are discovering it and even we're aware of it. That's wonderful.
Yeah. Very relevant topic for our industry. All right. So as we round out our conversation today, I've got two final questions for you, Mike. And the first one is really giving accountants or the accounting professionals some perspective on where the FreshBooks platform is headed. We already had a bit of discussion around the product features that even have come out since I started with FreshBooks in April of this year. But maybe just, is there anything in particular that the accounting community should be keeping its eye out for as we start to put out new product features?
So a couple of thoughts. One of the things I like to do, and one of the things I've learned about software is there's two ways to manage a product roadmap. One is companies that go ahead and disclose like the next 3 to 5 years of what they're going to build. And the other side of the house, and I'd say that's like, you know, well, whatever. So some companies do that. And some companies don't do anything. They just say, this is being launched today. And, you know, I've always liked the surprise and delight in that. And I know it's sometimes problematic if you find out your client gets something and you didn't know about it and that kind of thing. So fully aware of that. But my point is trying to trend away from forward-looking statements. So I'm not going to go and rattle through all the things we're going to go ahead and build. But what I will say is if you look at the pattern and read between the lines, from adding bank rec to journal entries to all these kinds of things, I think there's a lot more coming that you folks would be pleased about. And what we're looking to do with members of the program who are interested and Twyla will tell you more about how to go ahead and do this is collaborate with you on, hey, what's the priority and sequence of building out the things that you folks need? And in some cases, hey, here's what we have as like our model for how we're going to do it. Are we missing something and overlooking it? So we'd like to, you know, please know number one, that we're listening and we're looking for your feedback. And we want to go ahead and co-create the roadmap to some extent. We have a pretty strong opinion about what we need. And I think you'd look at it and say, yes, 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 and yes. But we want to go and refine that and improve upon it with your input.
Yeah, absolutely. And I have this conversation with new partners coming into the program all the time about how important it is that we gather their feedback around what they want to see inside of FreshBooks in order to enhance their experience using FreshBooks in collaboration with their clients. And I think it's fair to say that there's exciting things to come. And I know that as we kind of go flip into the next question, it's no secret that I'm excited about all the things that we're building now, because and not only does that enhance the experience for the client the customer, the owner, as we've referenced them as, but of course then for the accounting professional, which will just contribute to the growth of this program. So in that spirit, our last question then for you, Mike, before we go to Q&A is, as our CEO, what do you hope to see for the Accounting Professionals Program here at FreshBooks?
Well, here is kind of my vision for, you know, what success really is. And Twyla, you're going to have a bunch of work to do to get us there. But, you know, having been an owner, every owner needs an accountant at the end of the day. Now, we tried to create a world where they can go on sort of pushing that down the road. But certainly once you get to any scale and what have you. So I'd like to see every FreshBooks owner attached to an accountant at some point in time. And right now, it's a small percentage of people that are, whether we can see it or not. And so I think there's just so much value that we can bring to the small business community together by each owner having an accountant to work with. And so I think that's where I want to go ahead and get to and work with everyone to go ahead and make that possible and support owners in that way.
Yeah, that's excellent. And you know, I think that's still, it not only helps this community or this industry of accounting professionals evolve and continue to build out their firm and work with clients, but of course it helps business owners and queuing business owners up for success by having that collaboration with an accounting professional and helping them going through those learnings that you spoke about that every entrepreneur goes through. So it's kind of a double-edged sword in a good way in terms of helping the industry and also helping business owners. Excellent. So if we flip to the last slide, Paco, I'll just share a little bit. I know that this is kind of a few questions that were coming through as I was skimming, was a bit more than about the Accounting Professionals Program that we did launch in June of this year. This is the website where you can go gather a bit more information. You can also fill out the form to submit that you have some interest in joining the program. Just to highlight some of the benefits inside of the program, there's a new FreshBooks certification. So one of the questions to answer that with this piece here is that you do need to join a new program. So Mike talked about the previous program. This is an entirely new program. We have an entirely new certification. So expressing your interest in the new program is required, even if you're a part of the previous program. And then you'll get FreshBooks certified under the new platform. We've got a dedicated support inside of the program. So all the partners who join, they get a dedicated support team that has accounting experience that can talk debits and credits. This is something that was super important to me as we were building out the benefits for the program, is to have that dedicated team that you can always count on to answer any questions that you have. There's affiliate rewards that you get. You also get to pass along an exclusive discount to any new customers that you bring onto FreshBooks. You get a free subscription for your own use to play around, to attach integrations to really just get a feel for FreshBooks or even showcase it to a potential client. You also have the opportunity then to gain new referrals or new leads, which are existing FreshBooks customers who are reaching out to us and saying, I'm looking to be matched with somebody who is proficient in using FreshBooks and is FreshBooks certified. And then there's just ongoing resources, community, that collaboration around not only the product, as we spoke about, we want the product feedback, but the program feedback too. So this is a center for dialogue for us to be able to communicate with our partners and ensure we're adding value and ensuring that we're building up a program that you're gonna be able to continue to use, or a program that you're gonna get value from and a platform that you'll use with their clients. All right, so with that, I think we'll open up the floor for any questions. I think maybe a few have come through here, so let's see if I can answer or maybe even list these off. I think probably most of them, Mike, are probably geared towards you while we've got you here. So the first one is to please share more about the Factorama, about more info about Factorama and how that will change the experience of FreshBooks customers.
Great question. So let me explain what Factorama is and how it fits. So that's, by the way, so anyone who missed it at the start, and I know we had to switch between, you know, one video platform and another. So if you missed this, today FreshBooks announced our first acquisition of another company, a company in Factorama based out of Mexico. And so we're very proud to have that team joining us. And really, I think the short-term answer is it won't really influence the experience of using FreshBooks very much today. Okay, they are an independent standalone company and they are focused on the Mexican market. And what they do is that market, and I'm not sure how familiar everyone here is with the global market, but there's a government mandated e-invoicing protocols where basically if you want to collect money from somebody else, you have to register what you're gonna collect for what with like government standardized codes. When an invoice, it gets stamped by the government and then you send it and then the transaction gets stamped on the way back. And so it's really in having more rapidly and countries with a lot of fraud and people avoiding taxes and these kinds of things. And so long story short, there's other markets around the world that are doing this, and that was our interest in it. And we really, really like the team there. So in terms of use, you know, Factorama will not influence outside of like the Mexican market. It will not influence the customers using FreshBooks on the near term.
Great, thanks for that. Maybe in line with that about Factorama, I'll jump to a question that's relevant is to that response is, when do you expect to start working in Mexico and work in the accounting community in Mexico? Is there any date that we can be waiting for?
So great question. And Twyla, I think you can sync up with the team at Factorama to like get a highly refined answer to that. But they have a program today where they work with accountants is part of what they do. And so I think we probably want to start there because they're on the ground and more familiar with the market. And we're going to be working to figure out how our two offerings can work together, because they're primarily focused on invoicing, and therefore how do we work with more accountants where we bring, you know, a GL effectively, and they have some pretty country specific invoicing capabilities.
Great, thank you. Next question around users. So this question says, you mentioned you have thousands of users across 120 countries. Earlier, I think probably from your bio, it's reading that we have 24 million users. What accounts for this disparity?
So by the way, Gail, nice to see you there. If it's the same Gail Perry I'm thinking of, it's been a while. Thank you for joining us today. It's interesting. I hadn't noticed that I'd mentioned thousands, but we have, in over 100, and these are paying customers in all these countries. But long story short, the 24 million users is sort of since we started across a range of roles. And so we have paying customers in over 100 countries. And since we started using, over 20 million people have used it. And so that's, I don't know if that makes sense, but that's kind of how it breaks down. We do not have 24 million paying customers at this point in time. I look forward to that one fine day. But that is not at this point in time where we are.
Thanks. Next question is, would FreshBooks work as a personal wealth manager? I'm assuming this means, would FreshBooks be a fit as an accounting platform for a personal wealth manager? Is that how you'd read that question, Mike?
That is how I read it when I saw it before. And so I think what I would say to that is, I think if you were like an asset manager that is, tracking, financial statements across a variety of things, it may be less a good fit, and you want to find something more industry specific there. If you charge, a regular like monthly fee or invoice your clients for services rendered, I think it would be a perfect fit.
Yeah, that's what comes to mind for me is if you're sending out invoices each month, the FreshBooks could be a good fit. And maybe it's working in parallel with something that's more managing your clients as a CRM. It would be a use case that could fit just depending on the complexity, I think. All right, in South Africa, when can I join the program? And so my response to that is that currently we are really trying to focus on North America as we start this program. Now, that's really because of resources. We don't want to overstretch and underdeliver. As Mike mentioned, our 4 E's, that certainly applies to this program as well. That if we're going to execute extraordinary experiences every day, that we need to make sure we're set up for success and that we can give you the resources and the support that you need. And so in the near term, we're focusing on North America due to those resource constraints. And longer term, yes, we'll be looking at Mexico with our acquisition of Factorama, but we do have offices located in Amsterdam and in Croatia, and it is our intention to start to expand the program globally in order to support accounting professionals globally. We just don't want to bite off more than we can chew and under deliver on what we're trying to accomplish and the support that we're trying to give. All right, so will FreshBooks agree that they will not develop software and products with accountant like QB has done?
No, it says compete, but I think it's compete.
Oh, compete. Yes, that's probably supposed to say compete. Compete with accounts like QuickBooks has done.
So I think it is a great question. Twyla, you go ahead and just if I misspeak in any way here, straighten me out. But that is, you know, we do not want to do the thing, nor do we believe we can do the things where you folks offer, you know, the value that is intangible, it's consultative nature, those advisory services. Like, I do not know how those ever get done, you know, by software or certainly by us. I will say we have some partnerships with companies who offer a bookkeeping service. Okay. And so partnering with those, but again, those are largely what, you know, we have found, Twyla, you tell me if I'm misstepping again, but those can be helpful to help you elevate in your advisory service, to have a, you know, a bookkeeping automation capability through a partner that helps you do that. But, you know, but with that as the exception, that's the only thing I can think of that, you know, gets, you know, is gray in any way as it pertains to that question. It's just not our aim. We're building for the owners, and we want to help facilitate, you know, the partnership that they have with accountants. And the fact is, the most successful business owners all have partnerships with accountants, and there's many who could be more successful if they did.
Yeah, no, I think you've answered that well. And it is something that I'll have partners coming into the program ask about, is do we ever intend to offer, I think somebody else put in the comments, do we ever plan to do QB Live type of work, which is essentially having bookkeepers at FreshBooks. And, you know, I think it's two things there. I mean, even if with us suggesting that, I don't want to put the program globally until we're ready, because we can't bite off more than we can chew. And but more importantly is, I think FreshBooks has been really good at staying in its lane. And I would say that even since I've known FreshBooks, which is for a number of years now as an accountant, I would say we've widened the shoulders, but that FreshBooks has done a good job of staying in its lane and really focusing on this niche and what it's good at. And as Mike said, I mean, there's complexities to offering offering service. And that's part of our initiative around collaborating with accounting professionals who will fill that gap, so that when our business owners or our customers are asking for that collaboration and somebody to help them, that we have somebody to offer to them. It's not somebody who works at FreshBooks. It's somebody inside of the partner program. And so I think
we don't have any plans to bring that under our, and then we want to refer our customers to partners like each of you.
Yeah, perfect. All right, so next question, Mike, will you recommend to your customers through the support org that they connect with a certified FreshBooks advisor?
100%, 100%, 110%. I don't know if you want to build on that, Twyla, and if you've started connecting those dots as of yet, but I suspect you have.
Yeah, right now it's not in app. That's where we want to get to eventually. But yes, we've started to already do matching of customers who are reaching out, and we match them with partners who've joined the new program. So, yeah. Next question is, where do we go and get the certification? So if you go to that website that we've got up on that slide, you'll be able to see information, fill out the form there, and that kicks off the whole process to becoming FreshBooks certified. If I am I'm assuming this is either South Africa or South America.
Yeah, I think it's South Africa.
Okay, same one, yeah, okay. Can I be FreshBooks certified? Certainly would be happy to share with you through the certification training, so that you've got that under your belts and that you can feel even more confident working with clients using FreshBooks. Happy to make that happen for you. All right. Any intention to have a dashboard for accountants and bookkeepers?
So this is exactly, yeah, this is how we really help to facilitate the collaboration and be a better partner to you all, manage information between you all. So I think, you know, without being too explicit about the details or the dates, you know, directionally, I think that's just, you know, a necessary thing for us to go ahead and do. And, you know, I hope you'll be really excited by what you see when we get there.
Excellent. That's my response as well. So that's perfect. Are there any plans to integrate live bookkeepers into FreshBooks? I think we kind of covered that one, that the answer is no.
The answer is no.
Yeah. For now, how do we help clients in South Africa. I mean, a business owner needs an accountant. So I think this is probably that same attendee. I'm not sure on the name there, but yeah, certainly connect with me and can get you FreshBooks certified and boost your knowledge around FreshBooks and supporting FreshBooks customers who are looking for an accountant.
We can try and connect you as Twyla meets more people. You know, while the program may be less formalized in some markets, we'll meet people on the way and can help facilitate some of those.
Excellent. And then, do we have to redo the submission if we already have an accountant's login to work with clients' information? So I'm assuming you mean the submission on the website. That will depend. You can certainly work with clients outside of being part of the new Accounting Professionals program, and there's no harm in you doing that. And ultimately, like Mike said, the goal is to have every customer inside of FreshBooks have an accountant working with them, collaborating inside of FreshBooks. If you would like to join the new program, yes, then you would need to complete that form and kick off that process to joining as a partner by going to the website that we've got pulled up on the slide there.
Just freshbooks.com/accountants.
Oh, that's right.
Which is a slide. That's right. And so you can sign up there to become part of the program, even if you have been invited by a client, say, to go ahead and
Yep. No, and then how do you plan to include the big data push in FreshBooks and the accounting profession?
What this means exactly. I'm not sure how to respond in a way that I feel confident would be meaningful. The big data push in FreshBooks. I'm not sure what that is to begin with, and then to include the accounting profession in it. Is this something along the lines of, will there be, you know, information to help, you know, those of you and us in the profession to get smarter about how we do things and offer advisory services, benchmarking, that kind of thing. You know, I'll leave that to Twyla over time. I think that's not unlikely. Having said that, you know, it's hard to, I'm not exactly sure how to address the question.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure of the question. So feel free to ask it another way or add some additional insights there. We can come at that again. Okay, last couple of questions here. Somebody just following up. Yeah, so if you go, the question is, so do we go to the website, apply, and then wait for your response, correct? Yeah, so once you apply, and I see this in the chat here where maybe somebody is misgetting a communication back, and I will be back with you on that. But yeah, when you apply, you should instantly get an email that then tells you the next step. So once you fill out that form, you'll get an email right away that takes you to the next steps of becoming a partner. And does FreshBooks have an online store to purchase logo items for professional marketing reasons?
I think maybe Paco, you could flip a link or two, but not any formalized relationship, though many owners on our journey are interested in similar services. So I think there's not an official place that we send people, but there are some services that we found that are better than others. A local company used to be called Logo Joy and renamed is one that you might want to try and seek out.
Perfect. Oops, I forgot to move that one. There we go. All right. I think we've answered everything, Mike.
Okay. I just want to go ahead and thank those of you who stuck with us through the technical rhythm roll. It was, I know Paco had put a lot of time into helping us get on the best platform that we could to host the video and all these kinds of things. So thanks to each of you who chose to move over from there to Zoom. Hope you enjoyed it. So thank you for having me. It was a delight to be here. I think we're going to carry on and do a bit of a demo for those who'd like to see the product in action. The one thing I will leave you with as a thought is whatever you see today, check back again in 3 and 6 months and 9 months and 12 months, you're going to see an incredible rate of change. I'm cautiously optimistic. You're going to be completely overjoyed with the work that we're bringing forward.
Excellent. Thanks for rounding that out. Thanks, Mike, so much. And thanks everyone for being here. I will stick on, but appreciate your time today. Mike, go enjoy the rest of this exciting day that we are having at FreshBooks. Yeah. And thanks to everyone on behalf of everyone for contributing.
Thanks for your interest in the program. Okay. back now.
Bye.